What is going on, everybody? WeedleTwineedle here, and we are back again with another Sun and Moon Wi-Fi battle, and this one's going to be against Alison. Now, I battled my opponent on my Discord server, so if you guys are interested in Wi-Fi battling in general, definitely check out my Discord. We have a nice battle and trade community. A link will be in the description below. Now, looking at my opponent's team, yeah, it's a pretty scary team, though I did agree to having an OU tier battle, so I guess I can't really complain, but, like, really? That's like the as cookie cutter as you can get. Maybe replace Latios with like Tapu Fini, and there you go, man. That's pretty much all you need. But yeah, Landers, T Rotom, Wash, Pheromosa, Latios, Lele, and Metagross. The classic. I'm using Farfetch'd because a lot of people really wanted me to use Farfetch'd, so I decided to bring it to Blade, Relicanth, Hydreigon, Ludicolo, and Slurpuff. And I know it's not pronounced Hydreigon, but there's one person that says that and it triggers me so much, so yeah. I'm going to lead off with my leak strats, expecting the Rotom Wash to lead off, but instead she leads off with her Landorus T, which works for me because she actually gives me the Intimidate, which actually procs my Defiant, so it gives me plus 1 attack, so my Farfetch'd actually has a chance of doing damage. Woo! So turn 1 she actually decides to lay up Stealth Rocks. I actually thought I would outspeed this Landorus T, assuming because, you know, I am jolly max speed, I outspeed no speed investment Landorus T, but unfortunately, Farfetch'd is just so garbage that it's unable to achieve that speed goal. But thankfully, my opponent decides to attack me the second turn, activating my Focus Sashes. I'm able to knock him out with the Flail. And that's just a miracle. Farfetch'd being able to one-shot a Landorus T, you'll never ever see this again, so enjoy it while it lasts. As I'm not really going to enjoy it for very long, because in comes Pheromosa, and I'm just dead to the U-turn. So, leak strats, victory short-lasted, but no big deal. Pheromosa doesn't get an attack boost there, which kind of reveals to me that he probably is Choice Guard Pheromosa, because he's not Specs, and if he was adamant, he's probably Scarf, because most banded Pheromosas run Jolly. I don't know. It's whatever. But anyway, here I bring my Ludicolo, my K-Pasta, my legit shiny Ludicolo. That's actually not legit. I got it on Wonder Trade. But K-Pasta is a very funny nickname, so yeah. When I get funny shit on Wonder Trade, I use it. I'm not the kind of person that gets salty over hack shinies. If I get a funny-ass shiny on Wonder Trade, I'm using it. Shiny Ludicolo, I mean, I changed his moveset completely, because I already had a battle-ready Ludicolo, so that's why it's kind of weird. So the reason why I went for Z Rain Dance, ladies and gentlemen, is because Scarf Pheromosa is a quite speedy Pokemon. My opponent thought that, oh, I'm Scarf Pheromosa, I can outspeed you, Swiftson doesn't mean shit, I'm Pheromosa. And I'm like, nope. Z Rain Dance, motherfucker, plus 3 speed. Those are the drastic measures I had to take to outspeed Pheromosa. I know, kind of pathetic, but we're gonna go with it. Anyway, I would have loved to save my Hydro Vortex for this Mega Metagross, but unfortunately, to outspeed Scarf Pheromosa, one has to use Z Rain Dance, Swiftstone, and Ludicolo to achieve such goals, so not a big deal. We're gonna lose our Ludicolo to the Thunder Punch. Actually, we live though! Basically, I'm not high reacting to the battle. I thought I died, and I'm like looking at the bottom screen, like, alright, who am I bringing in? And then I realize my Ludicolo lived, so we're able to knock out the Mega Metagross. So I guess not having Hydro Vortex wasn't a big deal, but it was hilarious that I live with 1 HP. Oh my gosh. If I got my live reaction, you guys would have been dying. But anyway, in comes Jet. His legit shiny Latios is my legit shiny Ludicolo is going to go down to the legit shiny Psyshock. As down goes my legit shiny Ludicolo. I'm done saying that because I know that triggers some people. I'm not too sure why, as I'm just joking around and I can care less if they are shiny or hacked shinies because I can care less. But usually if you see a shiny Latios, your first guess is like, most likely shiny. But I mean, like, hey, if you got a legit shiny Latios, good for you. But I mean, I don't know, it's not a big deal to me. Anyway, in comes Relicanth, my 15,000 bells, a nice Animal Crossing reference for you Animal Crossing players out there. I unfortunately don't play Animal Crossing anymore because I only really played it in high school when I had free time, but unfortunately my free time now goes to YouTube, and yeah, I don't have much free time now, so you can imagine I don't really have time for Animal Crossing. But you know, we're in the city right now, so we're pretty much playing Animal Crossing in this battle. But anyway, we're gonna get the Toxic on the Rotom Wash. That was the main goal. I guess the Rotom Wash could have Volt Switched out, but either way, I'm toxicking, is that a word? Toxicking something. I'm going to toxic something. Yeah, we'll use that. But anyway, toxic the rotom wash, so now we can actually damage this thing. That is the main reason why I wanted to use Relicanth in this battle, was like, okay, Stealth Rocks, toxic the rotom wash, that's about it. That's all you're good for. As Volt Switch is going to do a crap ton of damage to Relicanth, but no big deal. She's going to bring in her Tapu Lele, as unfortunately, since I am burned, my Head Smash is not going to do much damage, but the Tapu Lele is going to come in here. I'm going to go for the Head Smash, and it's only going to do around half HP, but it's still respectable damage considering I am burned, and I have no attack investment whatsoever, so go you Relicanth. Unfortunately, I really didn't get to showcase Relicanth this battle, but I'm sure I'll use it a lot in the future. I really got to showcase Relicanth back in X and Y when Talonflame was in every other battle, but now that got replaced with Pheromosa and Lele, so unfortunately Relicanth doesn't do so great against those Pokemon. But in comes Umtablade, and I'm like, okay, I can't Shadow Sneak you, but you can't touch me, so unless you have like Ghost DMZ freaking Shadow Ball, if you do, holy shit, dude, you have the freaking elite mechanics, dude. The leak strats. You have the leak strats, like my Farfetch'd. But anyway, gonna go for SD as my throat dies there. On the Rotom Wash switching in, and now I'm just like, okay, I'm gonna go for a second SD, because if she's just gonna Will-O-Wisp me, I can't Shadow Sneak her because Psychic Terrain. Actually, yeah, I could. She's levitating, never mind. But still, better off I go for the second Sword Stance anyway. My throat is not working with me right now, so I kind of sound like I'm dying, but rest assured, guys, I am fine. I do sound different, because I don't want to clear my throat and kill your guys' eardrums, so I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to persevere. But anyway, my Deblade's up in here, and I'm just going to go for the Sacred Sword as the Rotom Wash chooses to go for Hydro. I'm actually able to tank it pretty well, and all I'm trying to do is just weaken this Rotom Wash to the point where I can just hopefully clean up the game with my Scarfy Dragon, because at this point, all she has left is Rotom Wash, her Tapu Lele, and their Latios, I'm pretty sure. And if I just weaken this Rotom Wash to the point where it is now, I'm pretty sure my Scarf Hydreigon can win the game. So, Shadow Sneak is just going to be able to chunk the Rotom Wash and knock him out. So, down goes the Rotom Wash, thankfully, as the blade is getting pretty low. But it's okay, we're able to weaken the Rotom Wash and knock him out, which was the main goal for it. So, in comes Tapu Lele. I would have loved to Shadow Sneak this thing as a new butthole, but unfortunately Psychic Terrain, or Psychic Surges of Will, you know, a very fair and balanced ability, so Shadow Sneak unable to hit it as the Tapu Lele is going to go for Moonblast and knock me out. So down goes my Deblade. No big deal, we're able to weaken the Rotom Wash, so I can bring in my Slurpuff here, and the main reason why I brought out Slurpuff instead of Hydreigon is because, you know, Tapu Lele is a fair and balanced Pokemon, it has decent defensive stats, so I don't think a Dark Pulse is going to knock him out, so I'm just bringing in my Slurpuff here, just to get the nice chip damage that I need to knock out the Tapu Lele, because I'm not risking that shit. Tapu Lele is a fair and balanced Pokemon, and I'm not risking it. So, gonna go for Calm Mind here, and since my Emburden is activated, I should be able to outspeed the Lele in the next turn, but because she actually reveals to be Scarf Lele, so she's running both Scarf Lele and Scarf Pheromosa, the skillful duo on the same team. Wow. But I'm gonna go for Draining Kiss and weaken the Tapu Lele to the point where Scarf Hydreigon should be able to clean up the game, which is only two Pokemon left. So I should have this game in the bag. Down goes my Slurp Puff. Unfortunately, Scarf Tapu Lele did cock block me once more. As now I'm gonna bring in my Hydreigon, and that's actually not its name. Its name is I Can't Fat, because Hydreigon doesn't have hands, kinda has mouths. That's probably a better trade-off in that situation, because then you could just blow yourself, but like, getting off that topic. Anyway, her last is Latios, her Jet, and I should be able to just knock this thing out with Scarf Dark Pulse, and thankfully it's not a random Scarf Latios as well. If it was, I'd probably kill myself, but thankfully it is not Scarf Latios, and they're able to win the game. So, yeah, that was a pretty fun battle. I had fun. I don't know if my opponent had fun, because her team is a little bit, not so fun, but I had fun, so that's all that matters. So that's gonna be the battle, guys. Thank you so much for watching the video. If you enjoyed the battle and want to see more of my content, definitely hit that like button. It really means the world to me, and it helps the channel grow, so if you want to help support the channel, definitely hit the thumbs up button. And the question of the day is going to be, what is your favorite game you're playing besides Pokemon at the moment? Let me know in the comments below. Now, since I have like no free time to play games ever, most of my free time goes towards Pokemon, but if I do play other games, it's most likely Fire Emblem or League of Legends. Those are the two games I mainly play in my other side time that I'm not devoting my time to Pokemon. So yeah, that's that. That's gonna be the battle, guys. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll check you guys in my next video. Alright, peace.